Welcome to Simucase. Simucase provides the learner access to real patient scenarios for case-based learning. Learners have 24/7 access to the growing library of simulations and over 1,200 interactive videos. As you enter Simucase, you will see that searching simulations is easy. In the simulation library, you can search by the type of simulation you're interested in, the topic area, the age group, or even the location where it was filmed. As we look at the clients and select an intervention, today we're going to take a quick look at Janine. Janine is 32 years old and has experienced a C4 spinal cord injury. The first thing we would do is look at the curriculum guide, which will level the content to the student, show you the topic areas, the learning objectives, and pair everything with the CAPD standards. As we enter Janine's case, students will begin to work in learning mode. You can see the progress meter here do fill when students make good choices, and we will start from zero. As we open the simulation, we'll first show the clipboard. Every decision I make will be saved there. We'll start the case study and get to know a little bit about Janine.
Janine is a 32-year-old who experienced a C4 spinal cord injury after a motor vehicle accident approximately 1 year ago. She is receiving mobile outpatient physical therapy, and you are the physical therapy practitioner assigned to complete Janine's physical therapy intervention in her home today.
Students will work with Janine following the clinical pathway here at the top of the screen. They'll first look at the baseline data, review the evaluation, they'll talk with collaborators, they'll complete their treatments, make client progress statements, and then a final summary. In this baseline data area, we meet Janine. And as we meet Janine, we can make decisions about what reports to look at, the questions we'll ask during the interview, and we can select the session objectives. The eval reports will be provided in PDF format for students' review. They can look at notes. They can also interview Janine. When I ask this first question, do you have any updates you would like to share with me before we begin? She will answer here on the right.
No.
I may ask, we are going to work on bed mobility today. Could you tell me a little bit about the progress that you've made?
I do have chain loops on the legs of my bed. I can pull myself up out of bed now. I'm able to roll in bed, which is pretty nice. I can switch positions besides just laying on my back at night. I can sleep on my side now.
You can see the next step would be to talk with collaborators. When we speak with the collaborators, we get an opportunity to learn more about Janine and our progress with our interprofessional team. As we move into treatment, we will select our treatments based on those session objectives that we selected here in the first section. Our treatments are going to provide a just right challenge. Students will have to select the treatments that are best for Janine. And when they do select a correct treatment, we will see progress in the progress meter. And we will be able to go through the treatment, watching the video, and answering these questions on the right. We will then move into client progress statements, where we will select the best statements that will tell us what the progress of Janine is in this session. And then we will make a final summary statement. When we finish, we will submit the case. Students do get an overall look at how they did and a final report to review. They will also get that same report on their learning page, and you will receive the information in your faculty dashboard.
If you have any questions, would like to schedule a demo, or are ready for a quote, please email us at sales@simucase.com or call 855-747-9547.